right? From that dark prison. It's making me go nuts. I can't fight it on YouTube, whatever. But anyway, I found this note to help the Fighters Guild. I came across an abandoned pack at the edge of the dark forest. The pack suggests that the members of the Fighters Guild might have been here. I should head into the woods and look for signs of the Fighters Guild members. The journal says this, I start out heading west and then southwest. Okay, boom. Finally right here, abandoned pack, that note from Camu. To any members of the Fighters Guild who find this, we are being pursued by shadow creatures of some sort. They look like Myrrh, possibly Bosmer, but this one can't tell for certain. Something in the forest called to us for Christmas, our aid. It was a voice apparently coming from the tower behind the walls. We have to find a way in there. Something important is in there. If you find this, meet us in the dark woods. We'll leave clues to where we are going as we can get. We need to get inside that tower. Please find us, Sergeant Camu. I'm guessing this will lead me into helping the king. Because I went in there, bro. And it's like, it's hella dark. And yeah, and it's just. The fuck? It's a captive. Anyway, let me stop talking.
It's making me go nuts, bro.
Hella strong. Someone help me.
Ah, free at last.
So that was nothing. Okay. Let's go find these guild members. Yeah. Nope, don't want to fight you. I just want to get this mission over. This place is beginning to annoy me. Hidden with clues and hella enemies that I don't want to fight. Find the Fighters Guild member above. Okay. I don't wanna fight you. Ah, so annoying. Die. Die, you little shit. Placed blade. This sword appears to be been deliberately placed so that the blade points in a specific direction. And extinguished campfire is still warm. So it's pointing this way. Don't want to fight no one.
Creature Aegis.
Hello. For right now.
By Ifra's hairy feet, you outsiders just keep showing up.
I'm looking for my allies.
You and everyone else in this forest, it seems. My clan has already declared your allies to be trespassers. You don't want to know what we do to trespassers. The Shadow Walkers will catch them. They always do.
So they're going to kill them?
Does a fuzzy newt goat have seven toes? Don't look at me like that. It's a perfectly appropriate analogy. Anyway, I hope I reach them before the hunters do. Otherwise, your allies don't stand a chance.
Why do you want to find them?
Because I'm tired of seeing people get hurt. Oh, things need to change around here. We've already spent way too much time talking about fuzzy newt goats. I really need to get moving.
How are you going to find them?
Have you noticed the swords left near these campfires? I think your companions are trying to tell us something. I'm going to keep looking for them. If I can reach them before the hunters, they might just get out of this forest alive.
Okay, let's go, beautiful elf girl. Let's go.
Keep your eyes open and your weapon ready. The shadows here are not your friend.
Mm-hmm, I've found that out. Whoa. Okay, so follow the direction of the blades, and then there's another sword right there, so it's pointing that way. Let's go this way. Shadow Walker. Got you. Take this, Shadow Walker. Die. Strong, you are strong. Die. Okay, so the sword. Sword points this way. Let's leave him, let him be. I already fought them. I want to help you out doing my quest.
You need to be alive. You have to be. I need you to help. I didn't do it. I swear. He was like this when I found him.
Yeah. So. Yep. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, talk to Ferenio.
This poor soldier. He didn't have to die. At least the Khajiit got away. How long can he manage to survive, though? I don't know. My clan can be very persistent.
Oh, so you're an old Shadow Walker, huh? My clan is quite persistent. Why is your clan hunting these soldiers?
Because we made a stupid deal long, long time ago. We became the guardians of this forest in exchange for power and immortality. But look at the cost. Now the Shadow Walkers hunt anyone who dare sets foot in these woods.
I need to help the Khajiit.
There might still be a way to save the other soldier, the Khajiit, but you need to trust me. I won't oppose my clan directly. They're my family. But I can help you find your friend. I just want to make sure no one else gets hurt.
Alright. What do you want me to do?
The Shadow Walkers use runners to search the forest, but you'll never see them. They become one with the shadows, all but invisible when the clan is on high alert. There is a way to see the runners, though.
How can I see these individual... How do I see these invisible runners?
You need to collect the bark of a Spriggan. The bark's magic allows the creatures to... How should I put this? Feel their way through the dark woods. Infuse the bark with the wisps of light, and you should be able to spot the runners.
I need to know more before I agree to this.
Your friend is out there, being hunted by my people as we speak. If you have questions, ask them quickly so we can get back to the task at hand.
Tell me about your people.
My clan is ancient. Older than you can even imagine. Our tree men tell stories of the before time. When we lived under the bright skies in the lush forests of Valinor.
How did you end up in Cold Harbor?
According to the stories, the Daedric Prince unleashed his fury upon Valinor. Instead of fighting back, my ancestors decided to offer their allegiance to the prince. And here we are.
So your ancestors just gave up?
Gave up. That's one way to look at it. Another way is to see a clan that wanted not only to survive, but to gain a significant advantage. The Shadow Walkers love power. In exchange for servitude, we were promised power over our enemies.
But you're different.
I explained this to you already. I'm tired of darkness and false promises. Molag Bal gave us power, but he keeps us trapped here. What good is power if we're stuck in this realm forever? I want to see clear skies and stars in the night.
I feel your pain. Goodbye. Okay, let's collect some Spriggans. I know you can find some Spriggans around here. Not you. Aha, there you are. You son of a bitch! Okay. Burn these little... Burn them. Fire Pokemon, bro. Ugh. That thing is fucking annoying. Freaking using a web throw to get me. Hit that fool. Okay, one more. There's one. Bring the spring and bark to Ferro now. Okay, where is she? Oh, that's so annoying. That was so annoying. Okay. I'm back. Hello, girl. How you doing, girl? She's cute. Anyway.
Did you get the bark? We don't have much time left.
Here's a sprig of any more before I agree to this.
Your friend is out there, being hunted by them. Did you get the bark? We don't have much time left.
Here's a sprig and bark.
Just scrape a bit off the top end. There. An old trick I learned living so long in this dreadful place. My friends thought it was funny to hide from me, so I'd use this to see them. It also has an interesting side effect.
Side effect?
While it allows you to see anyone hiding in the Shadow Realm, it also masks your presence from them. I've used this method to avoid patrols and sneak out of the forest. It really works. But remember, the effect is temporary. It doesn't last long.
So how does this work?
Touch the bark to a wisp of light, and then cross the bridge. The runners are searching for the remaining soldier. When you spot a runner, follow him. He should lead you right to your friend. And if the effect runs out, just touch another wisp.
Okay. Cross the alien bridge. Use the wisp of lights to see the runners. That was very stinky. There he is. So annoying. What's all that noise out there? Shit. Stop doing that. Die. 1.8k. Die. Die. Falcon Defensor. Talk to Sergeant Camus. Brigadine Guards. Where's Sergeant Camus? There you are. What the hell? Okay. The game doesn't open this nectar, but we have something important to do. But we have something to do. I know this to be true. Tell me what you're talking about. What the fuck? Don't tell me. Wow, that just ruined it. Okay. Tell me what was in the woods. We thought there was the other members of our expedition. But Captain Alfori breathed out. The voice comes from this tower. Who Whoever's locked up needs our help. And you will help us in the Would you not put the Lamia? The wood elves started harassing us almost as soon as we stepped into this red forest. They killed Captain Alperi in cold blood. I barely escaped. The snake thing found this one, lost and injured, and led me safely to the woods. And why are the Lamia and Farinova arguing?
This one isn't true. The little elf
was scared out of nowhere. But at least she didn't try to kill Camus, the other elves did. They both claim to know how to get inside the tower. But Camus doesn't trust either one of them. Head for the city to the east, it's safe there. I'll investigate the tower. Camus looks forward to seeing such a thing. Let me rest for a moment before I head out. I wish I could go with you. But until my injuries heal, I would only slow you down. Good luck, my friend. Do you have any advice before you head to the city?
I don't know very much about this area.
But this one always has opinions.
It's the least I can do.
What do you know about the wood elves?
They
are ruthless killers. They call themselves the Shadowwalkers. As far as this one can tell, they hunt and kill anything that enters these dark woods. They never even gave us a chance to beg for our lives before they killed Alfahor. What about Farinelle?
Saw her before.
She stepped out of the shadows, but she didn't attack immediately. It is apparent to this one that she is anxious about something, and she seems eager to help us. Perhaps too eager, what Camu means.
Deciding whether to roast slowly or leap right into the flames. There is no good answer. But if we were seeking allies, Camus would choose the elves. They are strong and capable. They could be a great help against Molag Bal. Well, the friendly snake thing did help me. We shouldn't dismiss them out of hand. They lack organization and fighting skills. But Camus can't deny their ferocity. Perhaps they are worthy of consideration as well.
We shall help you enter the tower. But first, you must help us against these foul wood elves. Do not listen to their lies. They murder children for no reason. Please, you must help me save the little ones.
The wood elves are killing your children?
We never asked to be dragged into Cold Harbor. We never made a deal with the Daedric Prince. But ever since we got here, the wood elves raid our nests and slaughter our children. This cycle of murder needs to end. You are a hero. You stride through Cold Harbor with confidence, and not even the wood elves can touch you. You can win this battle for us, and we will be in your debt. We will show you how to enter the tower, even help you in your mission. They are monsters. They destroy our eggs and slaughter my people. If you aid the wood elves, we can never trust you. The natives are powerful. We would be of great help to you, but only if you help us end our war with the wood elves.
I'll need to talk to Farinelle first.
I know you can't forgive my clan for what it's done, but they adhere to an ancient promise that will never come to pass. I can help you, though. No one knows that tower better than I do, but I need to ask for your help in return. It's important.
What do I need my help for?
You have to help me convince my clan to break this ages-old agreement. We've guarded these woods and that cursed tower, assuming that one day Molag Bal would reward us and let us return to Valenwood. But that's never going to happen.
How can I change the minds of the Shadowwalkers?
Like me, you've been outside this forest. You know about Molag Bal's plan. You know about the plane meld. You have to tell them that our agreement is worthless. How can we ever return to Nirn if Molag Bal destroys it?
What about the Lamia and her people?
Those monsters. We've been at war with them for ages. My people will never listen to you if you take their side. The Shadow Walkers are powerful. We would be of great help to you, but only if you aid me and convince my people.
Why should I help you? Not the Lamia.
You've seen my people fight. We're trained to kill. It's what we do. Maybe. Maybe if you can show them that Molag Bal has been using us, lying to us, maybe they'll see it's treachery for what it is and join your cause.
Well, we're supposed to pick one of them. I don't know, they made a deal. These people didn't. I'll just pick her.
We shall help you enter the tower. We never...
You are a hero. You will. We have waited such a long time for someone to aid us in our struggle.
It's messed up. I betrayed the elf.
Now we can get our children back. Now we can have our revenge.
That was good, Buzzard.
The violent, ruthless wood elf smash our heads.
Rescue eggs. You show me how to get into the tower.
We want our children back. We need our eggs.
Rescue your eggs. You show me how to get into the tower.
Yes, the tower. We will help you with that and so much more. But all of our eggs must be returned.
I will cover your eggs.
They hide our eggs in their filthy camps. You must enter their homes to rescue our children. But be very careful. Such an intrusion will result in great pain and death if they catch you.
How do I return the eggs to you?
I will find you near the wood elves' camp. I have ways of moving through the forest unseen. Can be dangerous, but worth the risk. I will do anything to get our children back.
How do I get out of this?
I will show you how to get into the tower, full of shiny treasures, I'm sure. And we will become your allies against the Daedric Prince. Even fight at your side, if that is what you wish.
Goodbye.
Wait, outsider. A moment more of your time. I get it. My people killed one of your own. They aren't evil, though. You have to understand. We signed a pact to protect this forest. The Shadow Walkers believe that if they fail to honor that agreement, we're all doomed.
They tried to kill me too.
Well, yes. I can't argue with that. I understand why you'd want to side with these creatures. I also know you need to get their eggs back. But my people don't need to die while you do it. Recover the eggs, but don't hurt my people.
Okay, that's more reasonable. Okay, I'll help you too. You're asking for a lot though.
I'm not asking for anything you can't do. And I'll go with you when you're done, to help. I've been planning to leave anyway, so now's as good a time as any. You can use me. Just don't kill any Shadow Walkers. Please.
Okay. How do I get into the camp full of bulldozers without killing any of them? Sounds like a Metal Gear Splinter Cell mission.
The Shadow Walkers watch the forest, but they're too confident. They leave the camps practically undefended. You could sneak in, get the eggs, and get out. You can do it. I know you can. Please, just consider what I'm asking.
It doesn't sound... It's reasonable. Goodbye. Okay, so... I thought they were gonna, like, hate me after I chose the snake people. And the poor snake people, you know, they didn't make a deal with, you know, Molag Bal. Her people did. So I chose them, and I figured, whatever, you know. Avoid killing wood elves, okay. Shit. There's one egg right there. Yes, I got one. Run, run. I hope they don't chase me. He's chasing me. He's chasing me. He is chasing me. I hate that. They literally chase you forever. Okay, no, they don't.
He was like, good. Cool. I don't want to kill no one, you know? I respect that.
You know, sometimes you just have to pick one thing and you can't do the other. I'm willing to not kill any wood elves and then save the babies. The snake babies. Okay, so where's the rest? There's one right there. Calcinium ore. Nice. Splinter Cell mission. Run. Okay, so... What? Shit. Why is he still there? Damn it. Standing in front of it. Oh. Enemies everywhere. Escape. I don't want to kill none of you. Don't chase me, please. Cool, they stopped chasing me. See, he's just standing in front of that. I don't want to touch that. I need that. Oh, I can't touch it? Damn it. Fuck. Ah. He never moves from that spot. See, I can't... Once you're in attack mode, or getting attack mode, you can't grab anything. I'm not like a Cro-Magnon, bro.
A what? I don't know if anyone that's like a Cro-Magnon.
You know what I mean?
You mean you ain't up in and skinnies. What the fuck was that thing chasing you?
Someone I'm trying to kill. Because, you know, that one thing, ultimatum. Mm. Pick one nigga or the other nigga.
Uh-huh.
I chose one nigga.
Uh-huh.
And the Wood Elves is like, okay, that's cool that you picked them, but could you not kill my people?
Hmm?
I was like, alright, that's cool. That's reasonable. You know what I'm saying? Because I want to save motherfuckers. That's just how I am. But she's like, okay, if you go in and help and get their little babies, don't kill my Wood Elves. So I was like, alright, but it's fucking hard, bro, because like this motherfucker is standing in front of the egg.
Hey, you know, it always comes down to one thing, bro. You're either going to die hero or live long enough. The funny thing is, I wonder if anyone ever plays, you know, this game like that. Like, they look at it as like, I'm trying to be a good guy. And then eventually they just say, fuck it.
How do I fucking get that egg? He doesn't move from it.
So what, does he chase you every time you try to get it?
He moves. Finally. Yeah. Because, like, once you get it on attack mode, or getting attack mode, you can't grab anything.
That's gay.
So you got detected, but I was able to grab it.
Yeah.
Cool.
So basically, being detected's okay. It's just if it becomes a hostile, you're like, shit. Then you're allowed to pick up anything.
Yeah, the sneaking in here is not as tight as the actual Skyrim.
Skyrim and shit.
They're
yeah.
more advanced in that game, especially in Fallout 2, but they don't have an ESO Fallout, so...
I was reading something that said with the Morrowind stuff that they're going to be like kind of upgrading a lot of the fucking ways this shit is. So maybe with Morrowind we might be getting a little bit more in depth or like fine tuned mechanics.
Yeah, and
because there's supposed to be a patch coming with it, so you have to pay for the upgrade, you know, to have Morrowind.
Oh, I'm paying for it.
It's like $60.
I've never played Morrowind too, so.
Morrowind is really bad, so I can like aisle and shit like. I played Morrowind way back in the day on the original Xbox.
Yeah, see, you played it before, I haven't. That's what's up.
Oh, that's hell long
ago. I heard that was a throwback. Everyone loved it. Werewolves, you were able to turn into a werewolf.
Yeah, there's a bunch of shit you could do in that one. Because I remember, like, what was it? You know what really pissed me off about Oblivion, actually? There is a vampire side quest in Oblivion that would fuck up a lot. Like, if you were trying to do it, half the time it would glitch up and it wouldn't let you do the quest at all. So you have to keep on reloading it and shit, well, eventually it would fucking fix itself.
That game is glitchy as fuck, but that game you could earn money hella quick with the scroll glitch. I love that shit.
In Skyrim, I think people did the soul stones instead, wasn't it?
In Skyrim, there was the book glitch all the way up north.
Mm-hmm.
There's like this little altar where you could find a book, and it always, like, if you don't take the book, it always regenerates. You could like double the book. So I would go to town and like sell them 50 bucks, but it was hella slow. That was the only hustle that I found out. I was like, oh, you guys are fucked.
Actually, you know, one of the best hustles to do is you get your most expensive arrow, right? Whatever the most expensive arrow is you can get in the game, you put one of those arrows in the archer's pockets that are doing the practice archery in one of the cities.
Yeah.
And then they'll keep on shooting infinite arrows of that most expensive arrow you gave them.
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah, that's what I did to get hella bomb-ass arrows. Because, like, I had the Daedric arrows, and I had the Ebony arrows, and then, I don't remember what the other ones are. Because there was, like, three, like, really high-class arrows. I remember, I think, Ebony and Daedric being two, like, the high ones, and there was another one that was better than both of those, I think.
That's me want to play fucking Skyrim.
I had Skyrim on PC, but I want to play on my desktop, and we're not getting the video card, for, like, after Dr. Summer's over. But I might wind up with a free Skyrim on PS4, and if I get the free Skyrim for PS4, I'll be like, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I want. Because I
want to play Skyrim Remastered, and I have it on PC already, but I kind of want to play on the PS4 because it's easier to stream right now.
Hell yeah.
I got to take care of some shit in the living room, and I'm probably going to hop on the Elder Scrolls, actually. I want to fucking make a new character, finally. Because I started over where, like, I got rid of the two characters I'd originally created, and I wanted Tori to make a female character, and then I was going to make the male character.
Yeah, me too. Just don't delete your, like, main one, because it takes... You always want one main high-level dude.
Yeah.
You could actually pass items into your bank, and your little dude could actually pick it up.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, that's fucking sick. So when you're broke as your new character, you could pass him gold. Fucking tight.
Yeah,
that's why I didn't delete this dude. I was about to, too.
I hadn't done anything on my cast yet. That's why I deleted both of them, because Well, one of them was based on the schizophrenic bullshit, right? You know, the fucking female bullshit I told you about, that craziness. So I fucking got rid of that character, and then I got rid of my regular character, and I wanted to recreate my shit to where it's like gonna be like Tori and my character. Like, it's gonna be Jay Sumner and Tori Sumner, because that's the fucking last name we chose. That's the one that we're gonna go with when we finally do our shit.
Oh, you guys are picking a random different name to
come. No, but we were fucking trying to come up with a name that, you know, was.
I'm talking about had, real life.
Yeah, real life. Real with a name that fucking has nothing to do with our families and shit.
Yeah, it's gonna cut off all family ties and it's just yours.
That's basically the concept of it.
What
so we're trying to make an original name and everything too. So
mine
it's spelled S-U-M-N-E-R.
Mine is Teodonis Gonzalez's.
Gonzalez's?
Yeah, I wanted to put like an old flair to it.
Yeah. You'd be the Sumness. S-U-M-N-E-R.
That's funny. That's tight.
Because we were joking about like one of the cool things, you know, it's like we want to be summoners of the dogs. So that's why we went with it without making it the complete word summoner.
Yeah, I got Annabelle in here as a pet.
That's sick.
It's a dune dog. The Alicare Desert dune dog. It looks the closest one to her.
I'll probably make a dog to be like Wi-Fi if I can. Do they have like a beagle class or something, you know, like the brown and white?
Well, what is it?
Can you like
see
colors and shit? Show me.
Where's our pets? See, there's the Alicare Dunehound, there's the little Acholyte, there's the Nibian Mudcrab, there's Axel, I guess.
Shoot, Shorthorn.
Yeah, I bought him too.
Shorthorn Shepherd is dope. Ooh, what? I like that little cuz.
See, he's hella huge.
That's dope though. That's Snoop Dogg status.
Yeah, you go, I think there's more pets. This is dope. There's more pets. I've seen the dude with a dwarven spider. I was like, what? I was using that for a while, the snow cub.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna make the male character tonight, and then I'm gonna wait for Tori if I can be down to sit down with me and make a female character.
I wanna make one for each pack. Hmm? One for each pack. Like, I want the Argonian to be like the champion for the Ebonheart pack.
Yeah.
Because. Yeah, because they all eventually join forces anyway. That's just my imagination. That's the way, you know.
Yeah,
that's the way I wanted to do it.
We're going to go with the Daggerfall Covenant for the first two characters, probably.
Yeah, that's where my shit
is. One reason I'm doing Daggerfall was first, I like the class and character that I can choose as far as, like, race goes. Because I think it was the Breton or some shit. Either Breton or Redguard.
Yeah, it's like the British people.
Yeah.
That's what the Britons are.
Yeah, so I'm going to have that one magic. For our first two characters. And then I plan on making a different character and a different covenant later.
See, because like for the Dominion, I want the Khajiit, the cat-like people.
Oh, that's the one that I wanted to make later.
Yeah, and then I like the second race I like the best is the Argonians, the lizard motherfuckers.
The first time I was playing this game, I actually made a Khajiit when I was playing an Outer Shift for a while.
Mm-hmm. It's those animal, the animal races are tight. Oh. Orc would be cool, but I'm like, yeah, I'm not a really orc dude.
I just wish they would make something a little bit more beastly, you know, like a demon beast type shit. Because our Arvinians are sick and the Khajiits are sick, but I don't want something that's like, I don't know, dude, just more of a mix, you know? Like a mix between like dog and cat or a mix between like dog and demon, you know? Like,
well, that's the thing that's weird because they have the Khajiit, but they don't have wolf people.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I want something like that.
I was like, why don't they just add that in the new Elder Scrolls?
They should.
I was like, where's the dogs? Like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
They're just cats.
I
mean, they're technically the werewolves, though.
Yeah.
That's a rate, you know, they kind of like cut corners with that one. Well, like, they're still humans, though. Yeah, there's not a legit dog, people.
Yeah, like, well, shit, I'm gonna go take care of this shit, play my game. But, I can't really play with your ass until I get my fucking ESL Plus. That'll probably be next month. I ain't gonna have it this month. By the time I get it, it'll probably be with Morrowind's house, so I'm probably gonna just fucking do the Morrowind upgrade.
If you're in the Daggerfell Covenant, what I could do is make a new character so it's not hella boring. So we both leveled up at the same time.
I am doing Daggerfall.
So. Or you just get my highest level dude and just like rip everyone. You don't. it's kind of boring
actually,
like that though.
I have to actually hit the enemy, so if I fucking like try to fight an enemy and you kill it before I touch
him. Yeah, you have to hit him one time.
Yep. So if you kill him before I touch him, I get no experience.
I thought that was tight though. All you need to do is do one hit, let your strong people kill them, and then you get all the points too. Like, that's tight. I helped.
I actually don't know. I'm holding those places. I don't like me.
George, I know, like, Noise Theater. He's the one who's like, thanks for online, and stuff, you know, deal with all fantasy, and, like, doing that, monster match. Like, any game that had that type of shit, we would fucking sit there and, like, one of us would have a powerful ass dude, and we would fucking rush all our other fucking homies' characters. We did that Shiny Halo 3, too, remember?
Yeah, that's pretty dope. Alright, back to this. Eggs.
How wonderful. My people will be most grateful to you for this.
I fulfilled my part of our bargain. Now it's your turn.
These eggs to our nest. But there is one more thing you must do before my people will feel truly safe. Please, may I tell you about this final task?
Alright, tell me what else do you want? Damn, girl, you're just asking me to do hella stuff. Get this key.
Is divided into two shards, each protected a Shadow Walker Guardian. As soon as you acquire the two shards, go to the camp in the center of the forest. My people will meet you there. Is there a way to get the shards without killing the wood elves? You insist on not harming the ones who kill my people. The little elf girl. She has confused you, hasn't she? Bah! Do you not know the ways of stealth? My people kill, and we do so proudly for all to see.
But you just said you could move to the forest without getting seen. And snakes in real life are stealthy killers. That doesn't make sense. But although this is a humanoid snake, so I can persuade you to convince you that I don't want to kill the wood elves. Persuade, I'm helping you, so I'd appreciate your help. Tell me what you know. Collect the Shard of Darkness, collect the Shard of Light, optional steps, avoid killing wood elves. Okay, cool. You're not making it easy, snake person, or Valley of the Light. This is gonna be tough. Oh no, it's those things again, messaging. Ha, I grabbed it. Let's go. I was able to grab it. I was tired. I used a little stealth. Shit, I don't want to fight you. I used a little stealth, my medium armor attack thingy, majig. Shit. No. I don't want to get killed by her. Run. Okay, I ditched. There's so many enemies. I haven't played ESO in hella days. Okay. Let's go over here. Son of a bitch. Shadow Butcher. Fuck, man. I was almost gonna take it. Damn it. And then there's Spriggans over here. I grabbed one crystal. I don't want to kill no wood elves. No, stop it. Breathe fire on that hoe. Die. Die. $4,600. Okay. Let's do this again. I just need enough time where it says take crystal. That's all I need. Yes. I should be invisible. This should make me invisible to take the crystal. See? That's how you do it, guys. Meet Lamius at the central camp. Just like, you know, you'll be able to, the mission earlier where you had to follow the Shadow Runner.
Hey, that pussy ass faggot that's trying to talk shit.
Yeah.
You know his team is?
Who?
Wolverine, Doom, Virgil.
That's what I thought. He had like a Wolverine on his team. Yeah. No.
I think I got a gay ass fucking team. He's trying to talk shit. He's barely a third guard. I could get third guard if I went and did bitch mode shit like that.
It's just, it's just
that's why I was laughing. Like, I just love that shit. He's a third guard.
Of course, he had to have top tier characters on the team.
And that, now he was like a Wolverine with like. With like Wolverine, Doom, and someone else besides Virgil, like a Dante, you know.
No,
like
if fucking Angelic.
Should Shuma Gorath have to be on Anchor?
I'm just saying, like, Shuma Gorath has not been used a lot. Like, they dumbed him down hella much, and Angelic is hella good. That's a good Wolverine player, and he's using Shuma Gorath.
That's
but this dude is like a typical Wolverine player.
Yeah, he is Doom and Virgil. It's like I don't mind the Doom thing too much because at least like most characters that use Doom, they have like some decent swag with them usually, and they know some of the more, you know, like advanced shit. So I'm usually not gonna hate on them too much.
But like most Virgils are the same fucking shit every fucking time. Well, I'm gonna Helmbreaker, I'm gonna fucking do SH, and do random stinger, and I'm gonna use stupid ass sword bell. That's it. That's all they fucking do. If you look at every Virgil, no fucking Virgil has swag. Like the only Virgil I've ever seen that have style is like Yipes, you know? But like fucking players that fucking they're pros, but we don't see them very often. Like that's the only fucking player I can nail off the top of my head that I'm like, oh, I like this Virgil. Otherwise, nigga, shut the fuck up. You're garbage. Like, okay, Clockwork uses Virgil, right? Clockwork, like, uses Strider Duke.
Yeah,
Virgil.
But we respect Clockwork because
he's
Strider
and Virgil off the bat.
Strider
though.
And Doom. He was using Strider and Doom way but fucking back in the day.
And the funny thing is that he plays Strider on point, or he plays Virgil on point, but he always has one of those two on point.
So he took Amaterasu out.
Yeah.
I don't know, but my nemesis fucking team with Dr. Doom. That's like my Clockwork team because the whole hyper team. I was like, that shit actually works, bro. The Color Assault hits him to the off the wall.
And then
Nemesis jumps on him. Then you go after. I was like, that's so fucking tight. I have to rep this team.
Hey, and you know what's funny?
My Doom sucks though, but you know he'll get up there.
Hey, check this out. You know what's funny about what you can actually do after that shit? You know how you web throw him? If you want, you can do a TAC. Don't waste any more meter. You can fucking just launch him. As soon as you fucking web throw him into the corner, just hit launch, jump up, one heavy attack into a TAC, whatever direction. And if you get the TAC off, well, if fucking Nemesis is next, just do the, you know, the fucking reset I was telling you about, the one where you can fucking do like the slow combo and reset him. Or if you TAC to Doom for whatever reason, Doom comes in, just learn some Doom TAC swag. So that way you're like, what, you wanna go shit? Nigga, what's this, Spider-Man? Okay, you like that combo, right? Here comes Doom. Foot on.
Doomy.
Okay, he really says it, doesn't he? He says Doomy. I should tell it no. When
he calls my brother Albie.
I was hella laughing when you said that shit. I was like, I think he said Doomy, and I listened to the game. I'm like, wait, what?
Yeah,
I didn't know he said it in the game.
Doomy.
I thought you were just being goofy. Anyway, this nigga's all garbage. I think he's online though, so I'm gonna fucking kick his ass on the first five. Whenever I kick his ass with one of my teams, I'm just gonna sit there and be like, hey nigga, you top tier, you motherfucker. Shut the hell up. Don't ever come to my stream saying shit again. I will seriously blow his ass up if that happens. If I get a first to five and I beat his ass, I'm gonna be like, nigga, shut the fuck up.
Well, let's wait one step at a time.
Hey, I'm not doing it yet. I'm gonna go a little high first. You know?
Maybe even kill him with kindness and be like, dude, man, you're good, you know. Maybe, you know, maybe sometime you'll be pro and everything.
I'll be like, hey, man, you know, if you ever need some tips, just come join my stream again. Dumbass. I won't put the dumbass part of that, but I'll be thinking after I say, come join my stream again if you want some tips, after I beat his ass. That's the time. I'm gonna beat his fucking ass. I'm gonna use a gay-ass team. I'm gonna use Frank West with fucking Taskmaster and Deadpool.
He said a gay-ass team.
I'm gonna make sure he's gonna be fucking not happy with it, because I'm gonna have fucking Deadpool in the back.
Just level up. Level up and chainsaw the hell out of him. Why not? You do it to me.
I could chainsaw the shit out of him, but I do like doing the level 1 combos. Level 1 and 2 combos are easy.
Okay, but if it's not working, just go straight freaking picture time, bro.
Yeah. No. I mean, the team is set up to where I can easily picture time. You know, like, if I want it, all I need is to get my 3 meters, and if he gets knee dropped one time, he's fucked.
Yeah.
He's seriously fucked. That knee drop is so funny because, you know, you can push their bodies when they're hard knocked down. All you have to do is, if you hard knock down someone, if you dash 3 times with a wave dash, they're basically in the corner. And then you do your team hyper. Frank West OTGs with the stupid shocking card.
Go play him.
Iron Man and Deadpool are fucking doing this shit, and it's after I'm like, no, you're staying on the ground with the arrow.
Holding up the story.
I gotta take a shit, but that's why.
Zig Nick, you promised your aid if I helped you. The Shadow Walkers has ended. You will have the help you need. But first, we must recover my children from the council. Did you acquire the portal shards from the guardians? I have the shards. Direct the shard key toward the portal instead of the arcs. The lamias will do the rest. Queen Fajik. I thought that was the Zeke, so this is Queen Fajik. Little snake people is crazy. Let us counsel fair against my children. What? Ends up a portal. Portal to the moon. What? They killed the wood elves. Of course. You killed the elders? What would you have us do? The wood elves slaughtered my people. They would not listen to reason. The only chance we had was to remove their leaders. Now, we shall watch the Shadow Walkers crumble. There will still be bloodshed, right? Will you show me how to enter the tower now? Instructed the ruined passage that leads to the tower. You shall find it there. Know that the Lamias are in your debt. Call upon us if you neither need our strength and cunning. Alright, Queen Fatigue. I help you kill the elders. Well, technically I didn't help you kill the elders. I just let you open the door and you kill the elders. Damn. Someone was about to die. Shoot. If I picked the freaking wood elves, the snake people would have died. The unusual circumstance. That's how you do that mission, guys. That's how you help the Shadow Walkers. I should end the stream. Alright, guys, I'm gonna. Right here, this is a new mission, I guess. Ruined Passage. Yup. I'm gonna stop the stream right there. Thanks for watching. I'm going to smoke a cigarette and then I'm going to do another video. Thanks guys for watching. It's your host Teddy Peso, and that's how you help one of the two. I know in YouTube there's not a lot of videos with that, but hopefully this video can help you. Don't forget to subscribe and press the like button. Thanks for watching. It's your host Teddy Peso. Chia, and I'll make another video.